Ever since Tehelka came out with Operation West End, we have had a distinctly new class of journalism in India. While in the developed world, hidden cameras have been used as a peripheral equipment or the last resort for journalism. In India, the situation has been very different, and that's in that context that you look at whether it's Cobra Post or before them Tehelka or others have been doing. In India, it's almost impossible or very difficult to get hold of government documents, official information, etc. It is in that context and forced by the secrecy of those realities, I think Cobra Post, Tehelka, and then Cobra Post came into being. So I think Cobra Post in many senses was a journalistic response to the socio-political realities of India. And I think because it was a passionate response, I think we have seen that it has had massive impact on several aspects and several walks of national life, be it the parliament where we have seen several MPs being caught on camera by them accepting money to ask questions or to offset the parliamentary proceedings, to showing how vast and expansive is the role of black money and manipulation in insurance and banking sectors. So their Cobra Post remains truly the only brand in India which has had consistently been producing high quality journalistic investigative work, and it has been impacting several aspects of our life. And to a large extent, a lot of people like me who ourselves take on investigative stories, we tend to spend a lot of time following up what Cobra Post is doing. That's a reality of journalism. Actually, Cobra Post has a larger role to play in India in the coming days, because there are several realities of Indian media and Indian politics that you cannot ignore. While many of us may not be able to elaborate the coming tidal challenges that we are going to see, I can very well put two, three things in perspective. One, for example, the large media houses of India are all corporate driven, and except maybe someone like Times of India, which is a pure media company, others are all extensions of other business interests. And increasingly we are seeing large corporate houses with interest in various sectors taking over media houses. So that's one context. The other context is, because media owners have several business interests, they are also trying to be on the right side of politics. And on the right side of politics and power is not good for media. So in those, in the face of such realities, I think Cobra Post has a far more important role in the coming days to play, because I think in the coming days, the challenge to establishment, challenge to those in power is going to be muted or meek or compromised. And I sense tension brewing, but not bursting out of the seams, because it will be contained for a long time. And that is where somebody like Cobra Post, an independent entity, will have to play and will play. And they will, I think, inshallah, with support and the right resources, I think they should be able to do a very important role in the national life. We have a cultural issue in India, in South Asia, in large parts of the world, where our successful entrepreneurs or businessmen do not naturally tend to donate or give in big terms, like what we see in the West, whether it's Bill Gates down to anybody. So there is a historical and cultural context to it, which is the old Protestant Christian tradition of giving back to society. And I don't know what reasons, but we don't have that culture of giving back in big ways. We give alms to our beggars, you know, few rupees, we throw pennies at them. But we tend to amass and keep the big properties with us for ourselves, for the next birth, or maybe to our progeny. I don't know what motives it may be. Alongside that, and so victims of this culture is, it's not just people like Cobra Post or other independent initiatives. You know, the funniest part of Indian media space is that the last big truly independent media trust came up in this country almost a century ago, the Tribune Newspaper Trust. We just have one truly trust run or independent entity that is in the media space. We need hundreds of trusts in this country, because it's such a diverse country. We have got so many languages. Every language, every district has a challenge of its own. We need independent responses to it. So Cobra Post and initiatives like that needs to be supported very aggressively. And this support cannot just be because we want to see Cobra Post successful. Cobra Post and initiatives like that will have very important role to play in India, especially to ensure that we move from where we are today, which is a very acutely chronic capitalist economy, into truly independent and true market economy, free market economy. So even for business houses and entrepreneurs, I think it would be a very welcome step for them to support initiatives such as a Cobra Post, because it is in their larger interest and in their good interest that we take our economy from chronic capitalist state into free market. And Cobra Post has already shown that it is capable of playing a very critical and crucial role in that transition. A very big story that Cobra Post has done, or the kind of story that people like we do, have all been contributing to improving the Indian democratic economic system into a more transparent system. And we have a long way to go, and we need to support institutions like Cobra Post. You know, there are two, three ways to look at it, but one, fundamentally, when you say non-profit, you are saying that immediately you don't make money. So immediate first response could be that it's non-profit is a way to go. But at the same time, I think if, let's say, Cobra Post were to be able to raise significantly large consolidated fund, which can be invested in diversely in good revenue streams, and in a growing economy like ours, it has all the potential to get returns in significantly good percentage terms. So if that is a kind of returns comes, we might be creating Cobra Post for next 200 years. For example, if you look at the Guardian newspaper in UK, while over the last few years when it went into losses because of the falling circulation and it is transitioning into a digital era, it is being supported by its trust, which is actually very financially quite robust. Immediately it non-profit is the only way for such large scale investigative stories. But if you want it to become institutionalized and be consistent, then we will have to look at Cobra Post and entities like that remaining financially viable, financially viable trust or independent organizations that has good money flow. And that should be where Cobra Post should go. So first create a consolidated significant fund which can be invested in various resources where revenue start flowing in, and that revenue should be able to sustain Cobra Post and similar operations. Sometimes I think that he's an overgrown child, sometimes. And I think that attitude of not taking oneself too seriously is his greatest saving grace, because in country like India, where every story of yours is billions of dollars of impact and you're taking on really big people, it's very important that you're able to laugh away threats, challenges. And Anirudh has huge amounts of fun in him, so he's able to laugh off a lot of those things. So even his government given security guards, I see him backslapping and making fun of them, but it's a reality of his life that he has to move around with policemen. And I think it's an embarrassing thing for any journalist to be walking to a source with an armed security guard, so Anirudh has, that's I think what endears him to friends like us, is the fact that he's very, he doesn't take himself too seriously. But I think what makes him very important to this profession is the fact that I think his value systems are right. He knows what he's supposed to do. He's very clear about his role in the society and as a journalist, which is very important, because in this country, a large number of journalists have forgotten their role to be the adversaries of the system. They've forgotten that their role is to challenge the system, to critique the system, to remain outside the system. I find, and we all find, that majority of us, or at least a significant number of Indian journalists, are in a great rush to get into the system and be friends with the people in power, and to host weddings and their birthday parties in their official bungalows, and take their favors to buy an apartment at a cheaper rate, to take all sorts of favors, and none of it is being seen or discussed as anything immoral, which is very frightening. And it is in that system that I think people like, especially somebody like Anirudh, has a very important role. And I think it's very admirable that despite his achievements and consistent track record over the last almost two decades now, that he remains away from outside the system. He doesn't play the ultimate insider. He actually plays outsider. And I think For a good investigative journalist, the best role can be that of being the ultimate outsider, but hitting the system from within. And I think he's doing it in a very impressive way, without sounding too serious, but keeping up the seriousness of the subject. I hope Cobra Post will generate good more revenue and more support, so that they can create a slightly more robust organization where they are able to draw in assistance of more experts who can explore digital databases, can link up to the larger global movements, can tie up with global investigative journalism or organizations that are doing large scale investigative journalism, so that Cobra Post not only remains relevant today, it remains relevant for tomorrow and creates a template for the complex digitized world that we are in.